knob. You've made up your mind awfully young, it seems to me.
Well, 30's about time to make up your mind. And I'm nothing of the sort, not Mr. Connor.
The time to make up your mind about people is never. Yes, you are. And a complete one.
You're quite a girl, aren't you?
You think?
Yeah, I know.
Thank you, Professor. I don't think I'm exceptional.
You are, then.
I know any number like me. You ought to get around more.
Yes. Not in the upper class? No, no. No, thank you.
You're just a mass of prejudices, aren't you? You're so much thought and so little feeling, Professor.
Oh, I am I?
Yes, you am, are you? Your intolerance infuriates me. I should think that of all people, a writer would need tolerance. The fact is, you'll never, you can't be a first-rate writer or a first-rate human being until you've learned to have some small regard for human Aren't the geraniums pretty, Professor? Is it not a handsome day that begins, Professor?
All right, lay off that professor.
Yes, Professor.
Now you've got all the arrogance of your class, all right, haven't you?
Oh, what have classes to do with it? What do they matter except for the people in them? George comes from the so-called lower class. Dexter from the upper. Well?
Well?
Mac the Night Watchman is a prince among men. Uncle Willie is a pincher. Upper and lower, my eye. I'll take the lower, thanks.
If you can't get a drawing room.
What do you mean by that?
My mistake.
Decidedly, you're insulting.
I'm sorry.
Oh, don't apologize.
Well, who's apologizing?
I never knew such a man.
You wouldn't be likely to, dear, not from where you sit.
Talk about arrogance.
Tracy.
What do you want?
You're wonderful. There's a magnificence in you, Tracy.
Now, I'm getting self-conscious. It's funny, I... Mike, let's...
Yeah?
I don't know. Go up, I guess. It's late.
Magnificence that comes out of your eyes and your voice and the way you stand there and the way you walk. You're lit from within, Tracy. You've got fires banked down in you. Hearth fires and holocausts.
I don't seem to be made of bronze.
No, you're made out of flesh and blood. That's the blank, unholy surprise of it. Oh, you're the golden girl, Tracy. Full of life and warmth and delight. Well, what goes on? You got tears in your eyes.
Shut up, shut up. Oh, Mike, keep talking, keep talking. Talk, will you?
No, no, I've stopped.
Why? Has your mind taken hold again, dear Professor?
Well, good thing, don't you? Do you agree?
No, Professor.
All right, lay off that Professor stuff now. Do you hear me?
Yes, Professor.
It's really all I am to you, is it?
Of course, Professor.
Are you sure?
Why, yes. Yes, of course. Golly.
Tracy.
Mr. Connor, Mr. Connor.
Let me tell you something,
No, don't.
Tracy.
All of a sudden, I've got the shakes.
It can't be anything like love, can it?
No, no, it mustn't be. It can't.
Would it be inconvenient?
Terribly. Anyway, I know it isn't. Oh, Mike, we're out of our minds.
Right into our hearts.
That old type music.
Yeah, it does, doesn't it? Tracy,
oh,
you're so
as if my insteps were melting away. What is it? Have I got feet of clay or something?
Tracy.
It's not part of the pool. It's just over the lawn and in the birch grove. It'll be lovely now.
Tracy, you're tremendous.
Put me in your pocket, Mike.